The game of Survivor brings people together from all different walks of life. Sometimes bonds form between people you would least expect. G'day guys, welcome back to Snuffed, where we discuss everything about the greatest game on television, Survivor. Today we'll be counting down the five greatest bromances in the show's history. Some of these bromances have lasted all the way to the end, others not nearly as long. One thing's for sure though, that these relationships have brought polar opposites together and created some iconic moments on the show. We kick off the list with number 5, Charlie Herschel and Marcus Lehman from Survivor Gabon. The pair entered the game as members of the Kota tribe and immediately formed a strong bond on day one, with Marcus playing up to Charlie and using his flirting as a tool to gain his trust. Together, Charlie and Marcus made up the inner layer of the Onion Alliance, luring in Jackie, Corinne and Bob to gain control of the Kota tribe. They remained together through the first tribe swap, proving inseparable until they were eventually split up during the second tribe switch. And Marcus was voted out on day 24 before the merge, which damaged Charlie's position in the game and saw him voted out not long after.
I feel that I have a special bond with Marcus. Ever since I saw him on the mat and he picked me, I just felt this connection in his deep blue, beautiful eyes.
Do you think I had any doubt that you're a well-balanced human being? Like, I wouldn't be talking to you like this if I did, so.
Okay, cool. Okay. It feels good to like trust one person at least.
Yeah.
The thing with Charlie is, I think he's attracted to me, but you know, I'll be honest, like I don't see any romance with Charlie and I think he's a great guy. You know, I can see that he's handsome and smart and all those things. And I really can appreciate that about him. This is not really the way I roll.
You're a nice guy and you know it.
Yeah, I'm chill, that's all. I'm straight, so we're in Eden, but there's no two Adams here.
The fourth greatest Survivor bromance of all time was between Coach Wade and Tyson Apostle in Survivor Token Sheens. They began the season on the Timbira tribe together with Coach wanting to take the strongest to the end. He immediately took Tyson under his wing, whom he dubbed his assistant coach. The pair worked closely together in plotting the elimination of Candace and were instrumental in forming the Warrior Alliance with JT and Steven, which they used to get rid of their biggest adversary, Brendan, otherwise known as the Dragon. Tyson would be blindsided at the following tribal council, but the pair were once again reunited in Heroes vs. Villains, where they rekindled their bond as members of Boston Rob's alliance, before Tyson once again screwed himself over and fell victim to a genius plan concocted by Russell and Parvati. Coming in at number 3, we have one of the most iconic duos in modern Survivor, that is Dominic Abate and Wendell Holland from season 36, Ghost Island. The pair started out in the Navidi tribe where they built a strong bond which was solidified after Sebastian told Wendell he wanted Dominic out, only for Wendell to notify Dominic about it and establish a great level of trust. They stuck together through the tribe swap, recruiting Jonathan and Laurel along the way and setting their target on Chris Noble. Dom and Wendell spent a brief period apart following the second tribe swap, but when the merge came on day 20 they reunited and finally sent Chris home, taking control of the game with Dominic as the master strategist and Wendell as the cool, composed social player. Wendell thought about possibly getting rid of Dominic to make a move and win the jury's respect, but it didn't play out and eventually Dominic would go on to win final immunity. He considered going against Wendell in the fire-making challenge to take out the biggest threat, but knew it was too big of a risk. Wendell would go on to beat Angela in firemaking and they would go head-to-head at Final Tribal Council with Laurel also along for the ride. Speaking of just how neck-and-neck they were in the entire game, Wendell and Dominic held the first tie at a Final Tribal Council in Survivor history, winning 5 votes each before Laurel went on to cast the final vote in favour of Wendell. Had they not stuck by each other's side and remained loyal the entire game, it may have ended up that neither would have reached the final three, and while Wendell got the last laugh, both are considered to be fantastic players and one of the greatest modern Survivor duos. Before we discuss the two greatest Survivor bromances of all time, we should pay attention to some honourable mentions. Caleb Reynolds and Ty Trank first appeared together on Koh Rong as members of the Beauty Tribe and formed an unlikely bond from day one. When Caleb was medevaced though, their time together was cut short, but they would ultimately enjoy a second outing together on Game Changers. Adam Klein and Jay Starrett shared an interesting relationship on Millennials vs Gen X as opposition to each other, butting heads from day one on the Millennials tribe, but their shared personal experiences back home saw their rivalry put aside, growing close in a way only brothers could toward the end of the game. Many would have thought that Christian Hubicki would be the first to go on the Tiva tribe, especially when considering the strength of his tribe mates, but he was taken in by John Hennigan and Dan Rangarin and ingratiated himself as one of the Brochachos, proving to be a force to be reckoned with. The second best Survivor bromance is not in a sexual way, that's for sure. Starting on the Tuggy tribe in Survivor Borneo, many would have thought the former Navy SEAL Rudy Bosch would clash with Richard Hatch, a corporate trainer from Newport, Rhode Island, But it turned out to be quite the opposite as the pair bonded closer with each passing day on the island. Richard was unsure as to whether he should reveal the fact that he was homosexual to Rudy, believing it would ruin any relationship they had built up until that point, but speaking of just how close they had become over the first few days, Richard was surprised that Rudy was comfortable around him despite his sexuality and that he still thought very highly of him. The pair dominated the game from beginning to end as part of the Tuggy Four, reaching the final three together before both dropped out of the final immunity challenge, leaving Kelly Wigglesworth to decide to bring Richard to final tribal council, deeming Rudy to be a bigger threat. Rudy went on to cast his vote to win for Richard, and the pair remained close friends outside of the game until Rudy's death in 2019.
But anyway, me and Richard got to be pretty good friends. Not in a homosexual way, that's for sure.
And finally, coming in at number one, they're possibly one of the most unique pairs to bond. Coming from completely different backgrounds, they originally met on the Samburu tribe in Survivor Africa, and Brendan and Frank got along well from day one. Well, while Brendan and Frank did enjoy a cute date in Africa, they really don't hold anything against the unlikely friendship that formed between JT Thomas and Stephen Fishback in Survivor Token Chains. JT and Stephen began their journey on the Jalapau tribe, and Stephen was unsure as to how he felt about JT's position in the game. JT immediately became very popular and well-liked by his tribe mates, which made Stephen uncomfortable, and he felt as though he was the odd one out. As he began to get to know JT, though, he realised that the two of them could work together, setting up an alliance with Taj that saw them eliminate Sandy, Spencer, and Sydney, sharing an idol between them and resulting in them reaching the merge. The pair found themselves stuck in the middle between Brendan and Sierra and Coach and Tyson's alliance, and ultimately decided to stick with Coach and Tyson to form the Warrior Alliance. JT and Stephen began to dominate the game, playing perfectly off each other with JT's social game and Stephen's strategic sensibility. It took them all the way to the final three, where they stood with Aaron, and while Stephen considered Cudden his closest ally in the game, ultimately they shared breakfast on day 39 after JT elected to take Stephen with him to the final two, where he won in a unanimous 7-0 vote. JT and Stephen seemed like an unconventional alliance, but that is what made them such a great team, working closely together throughout the game to defy the numbers and overcome a 6-3 minority. Did we miss any Survivor bromances? Let us know in the comment section down below. If you enjoy what you've seen, I'd really appreciate it if you give this video a like and consider subscribing to the channel for all the fixins. New videos just like this one every Tuesday and Thursday, 7:30 p.m. Eastern Time. That's Wednesday and Friday Australian Time. While showmances have proven to be deadly, you should never underestimate how far two bros can go in the game together. Grab your torches, head back to camp. Good night.
Frank is somebody that in my real life I would never be around.
Frank is very abrasive and, you know, kind of cold, and he doesn't have that kind of warm side to offset his less than charming personality.
Take the cards that I'm dealt with and make the best of them. It was difficult enough for me personally, but hey, it's a movie. You be quiet and watch the damn movie. Yeah, the company could have been better, but we simply had popcorn, we had pop, we watched a movie. It's history, it's over with. Let's move forward.